And we're back. What are we looking at today? We're looking at Starfox. That's right. Starfox is back on the Nintendo Switch. Is he really? Not really. Kind of. We're actually looking at Starlink, a game developed by Ubisoft that includes Starfox as one of the characters within the game. Let's roll that intro. Alright, so let's open up Starlink. Starlink Battle for Atlantis. Definitely some great looking Star Fox characters inside, as well as some DLC that will be included as part of the game. Let's open up this box and see what's inside. You know, although we can already see what's inside, but let's have a closer look. Looks like two figurines. A spaceship of some sort and two other thingy. Let's find out. Let's get that out of this box. Oh, there's the game underneath. Wow, look at the detail on those. That looks great. What's inside? Looks like some sort of poster of some sort. And there's that game that I was talking about earlier. So it is an actual cartridge that's included, not like the previous Sonic game that we had that included only a DLC card. There we go, Star Fox himself. Nice, very well detailed, nice figurines. All right, some sort of missile launcher, rockets, I guess. Weaponry, I guess, maybe, for the ship. This ship, let's set that on the stand. Perfect. There we go. Wow, looks great. I'm sure both of us will have to fight over who's gonna get to keep it on their desk. I think I might take it. Yep, there's the game. Thank God. I hate it when these manufacturers give you a physical box with accessories and inside you get a DLC card that says, here, download this game. If I want to download the game, I would have bought it online from the store. Good on these guys for including an actual cartridge. Alright, let's open this up and see what it really looks like. Nice, great, well-detailed poster. Those are all the figurines and action and spaceships you can purchase. Who knows when Nintendo is actually going to release a Star Fox game, but this is definitely the next closest thing we can get. I mean, it's space battle, there's Star Fox in it, and it's two-player co-op fun. Now, the only limitation is it doesn't support two-player in handheld mode. You definitely have to plug it into your TV. I guess the system has that limitation. It's not strong enough or powerful enough to allow two players to play this game together, unless you connect it to the TV. There we go. Look at those. Very well detailed, very nice looking figures. Is this game worth it? We think so. We had a lot of fun playing this game. Plays great. Big improvement over, I don't know why we keep comparing it to Star Fox, but that's the closest thing that we can because it's a very similar type of game. I mean, they include the guest pilot, Fox McCloud himself, an Arwing. You get extra missions that are, you know, aligned with the Star Fox story. You get a flamethrower, you get the frost barrage. Mason Rana, digital Zenith ship, controller mound, the poster. It's great. We love this little collection. It's been out for a while, so it's definitely available at a discount. Keep in mind that the Starlink versions for the PS4 and the Xbox One do not include Fox McCloud. This is a Nintendo Switch exclusive. All the boxes look pretty much the same on retail shelves, but the figures and the missions and all of the stuff that I mentioned is only available on the Nintendo Switch. So make sure that if you want this version, this is the one to pick up. If you don't really care about the action figures and all that stuff that came out of the box, I mean, yeah, you can definitely buy the digital version, no problem, on any one of the three platforms. But for this content, you definitely have to jump aboard the Nintendo Switch version. And we did. We love Star Fox. We always did. And we definitely enjoy Starlink as well. Hope you guys enjoy this video. And as always, take care. See you guys next time.